running. Head out on the highway.
It's annoying to me now to read every time it's discussed in the press or in Congress that it simulates the feeling of drowning. It doesn't simulate the feeling of drowning. You are being drowned slowly.
I like smoking lightning. Heavy metal thunder. Racing with the wind. And the feeling that I'm under. Yeah, I gotta go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. Buy all of the guns and guns and explode into space.
We signed an agreement saying we will not torture. So anything a president said he believes is torture would specifically be, if we then employed it, would be in violation of the Geneva Accord. So I think it's very important for presidents not to go through a list of this is torture and that's, I mean, how many days without sleep is torture? I just don't want to publish that for the benefit of the terrorists, and I don't want to do something which would ever cause our nation to be in violation of an agreement that we had signed. The issue that you always face is what happens in that very terrible circumstance, the ticking time bomb circumstance. My view is, in that circumstance, the President of the United States should be the person that makes the call. You don't say to a CIA operative, hey, you're violating the law, but unless you do, the whole nation's gonna get, you know, a devastating attack. You have the President make that call. But I would oppose any form of torture, and I'm not planning on laying out what those forms are, line and verse.
I do not believe that as a presidential candidate, it is wise for us to describe precisely what techniques we will use in interrogating people. I oppose torture. I would not be in favor of torture in any way, shape, or form.
Is waterboarding torture?
And as I just said, as a presidential candidate, I don't think it's wise for us to describe specifically which measures we would and would not use. And that is something which I would want to receive the counsel, not only of Senator McCain, but of a lot of other people. And there are people who for many, many years, get the information we need to make sure that we protect our country. And by the way, I want to make sure these folks are kept at Guantanamo. I don't want the people that are carrying out attacks in this country to be brought into our jail system and be given legal representation in this country. I want to make sure that what happened to Khalid Sheikh Mohammed happens to other people who are terrorists. He was captured. He was the so-called mastermind of the 9/11 tragedy. And he turned to his captors and he said, I'll see you in New York with my lawyers. I presume ACLU lawyers. So that's not what happened. He went to Guantanamo and he met GIs and CIA interrogators. And that's just exactly how it ought to be.
Senator McCain, there are reports Khalid Sheikh Mohammed was waterboarded.
Well, Governor, I'm astonished that you haven't found out what waterboarding is.
I know what waterboarding is, Senator.
Then I am astonished that you would think such a torture would be inflicted on anyone in our who we are held captive, and anyone could believe that that's not torture. It's in violation of the Geneva Conventions. It's in violation of existing law. And, Governor, let me tell you, if we're going to get the high ground in this world and we're going to be America that we have cherished and loved for more than 200 years, we're not going to torture people. We're not going to do what Pol Pot did. We're not going to do what's being done to Burmese monks as we speak. And I suggest that you talk to retired military officers and active duty military officers like Colin Powell and others. And how in the world anybody could think that that kind of thing could be inflicted by Americans on people who are held in our custody is absolutely beyond me.
Governor Romney, 30 seconds to respond, please.
Senator McCain, I appreciate your strong response, and you have the credentials upon which to make that response. I did not say, and I do not say, that I'm in favor of torture. I am not. I'm not going to specify the specific means of what is and what is not torture, so that the people that we capture will know what things we're able to do and what things we're not able to do. Yes. And I get that advice from Kofor Black, who is a person who was responsible for counterterrorism in the CIA for some 35 years. I get that advice by talking to former generals in our military, and I don't believe it's appropriate for me as a presidential candidate to lay out all of the issues one by one. Fine. Get questioned one by one. Is this torture? Is that torture?
Senator
McCain, so that's something which I'm going to take your and other people's counsel on.
Senator McCain, 30 seconds to respond.
Well, then you would have to advocate that we withdraw from the Geneva Conventions, which were for the treatment of people who were held prisoner, whether they be illegal combatants or regular prisoners of war, because it's clearly the definition of torture. It's in violation of laws we have passed. And again, I would hope that we would understand, my friends, that life is not 24 and Jack Bauer. Life is interrogation techniques which are humane and yet effective. And I just came back from visiting a prison in Iraq. The Army general there said that the techniques under the Army field manual are working and working effectively, and he didn't think they need to do anything else. My friends, this is what America is all about. This is a defining issue. And clearly, we should be able, if we want to be Commander-in-Chief of the U.S. Armed Forces, to take a definite and positive position on, and that is we will never allow torture to take place in the United States of America.
Mr. Cain, Stephen writes, I served on an aircraft carrier during the Vietnam War. I believe that torture is always wrong in all cases. What is your stance on torture?
I believe in following the procedures that have been established by our military. I do not agree with torture, period. However, I will trust the judgment of our military leaders to determine what is torture and what is not torture. That is the critical consideration.
Mr. Cain, of course, you're familiar with the long-running debate we've had about whether waterboarding constitutes torture or is it an enhanced interrogation technique. In the last campaign, Republican nominee John McCain and Barack Obama agreed that it was torture and should not be allowed legally, and that the Army Field Manual should be the methodology used to interrogate enemy combatants. Do you agree with that or do you disagree, sir?
I agree that it was an enhanced interrogation technique.
And then you would support it as president. You would return to that policy.
I would return to that policy. I don't see it as torture. I see it as an enhanced interrogation technique.
Congresswoman Bachman, your opinion on this question that our emailer asked.
If I were president, I would be willing to use waterboarding. I think it was very effective. It gained information for our country. And I also would like to say that today, under Barack Obama, he is allowing the ACLU to run the CIA. You need to understand that today, when we interdict a terrorist on the battlefield, we have no jail for them. We have nowhere to take them. We have no CIA interrogation anymore. It is as though we have decided we want to lose in the war on terror under President Obama. That's not my strategy. My strategy will be that the United States will be victorious in the war on terror.
Despite saying that he won't make a practice of commenting on what's said in Republican primary debates, the president did respond to the endorsement by Michele Bachman and Herman Cain of the interrogation tactic of waterboarding.
Let me just say this, they're wrong. Waterboarding is torture. It's contrary to America's traditions. It's contrary to our ideals. That's not who we are. That's not how we operate. We don't need it in order to prosecute the war on terrorism. And we did the right thing by ending that practice.